Mickey Menzel tritt gegen den U21-Weltmeister von 2013 an. 23 Jahre jung, vor ein paar Wochen Vater geworden und er sorgte für einen riesen Paukenschlag bei der letzten Weltmeisterschaft, als er Phil Taylor aus dem Turnier schlug. Viele Spieler sagen, das ist ein zukünftiger Weltmeister. Auf ihn freuen wir uns. Herzlich willkommen hier in Berlin, Bully Boy Michael Smith.
Next up on stage then, it's the battle of the two Michaels. Michael Mansell from Northern Ireland, the left-hander, up against Michael Smith from St Helens, and Elmar Air MC mentioned the name Phil Taylor. That is still Michael Smith's claim to fame, knocking Phil Taylor out of the World Championships at Alexandra Palace earlier this year. But he's someone who has been a dangerous opponent, especially on the youth scene, for a number of years. Alongside me, delighted to say, Rod Harrington. And Rod, just a word about the last game on stage. Raymond van Barneveld being seen off by Ronnie Baxter. We saw Ronnie play the first European Tour event here in Germany in fantastic form and go all the way to the semi-finals. But Barney just looking a bit out of sorts. Maybe one game too far today, having played in Aberdeen on Thursday night in the Premier League and then playing in the qualifiers here last night.
Yeah, possibly, Mike. Last night, I have to say, is down to himself. Ducking out of tour events over the last 12 months, and as we said before, you know, the rankings are gone on the Pro Tour, not the world ranking, and that's why he's had to come through the qualifiers. If he'd have played more tour events, he obviously, with his ability, would have got more points and been an automatic qualifier. So that's down to him. But even so, you know, going to Aberdeen, it's a flight there and a flight, you know, back to here early morning to play the qualifiers and then the game. But that's the nature of the beast, I'm afraid. You know, every sportsman has to go for it. Footballers are playing, you know, all across Christmas, all right, and two or three times a week and training. The same with golfers. And, you know, if you want to earn a lot of money at a professional sport, then that's what you have to do. He'll get over it. He's good enough. And we'll have you. But Baxter, you know, that was always going to be a tough game. One of the most toughest competitors.
Yeah. I was going to say, let's not take anything away from the fantastic performance by Ronnie Baxter.
Yeah, you're exactly right. He's been a tough competitor for probably 30 years now. And it was the hardest round, the hardest first round draw for me, that one. But now to this one, Mickey Mansell, total contrasting throws here. Mickey Mansell, really deliberate. Where Michael Smith, put him in the category of the Lewis and Van Gerwen and Gary Anderson. The very fast, fluid, power scoring that Smith possesses.
So it is Mansell to throw first, with Mervyn King, who's been on some good form himself on the European Tour, awaiting the winner of this one. And what a way to kick off the game. There is no better way, in fact, than a 180 for the left-hander. And what a way to respond.
Anything you can do, I can match. Great start to the game. I think that's the third, maybe fourth leg this afternoon that started with maximum. But Mansell there not following it up, so a chance here for Smith. A little wry smile there when he puts it in the five. Yeah, that's a great response from Michael Smith. Follows the 180 up with another two treble visit.
I mentioned Smith beating Phil Taylor at Alexandra Palace, went on to lose to eventual finalist Peter Wright in the next round, round three. Also lost to Peter Wright in the third round of the UK Open, and has reached three quarterfinals on the Players' Championship so far, Michael Smith. So he's on pretty decent form coming here to Berlin. But it is a big finish then required for Michael Mansell to hold his throw. and take an early 1-0 lead. Well, that knocks off the odd one, but Michael Smith then 41. Will need three darts from 99.
Yeah, although Mansell's on the Shanghai in the 20s and didn't put a great deal of pressure on. Michael Smith going for two double tops there, but leaves the double top, so pressure on Mansell to hold his throw. Shanghai on the 20s. If he misses his treble 20, he wants it just above it. Oh, he's put it straight in the middle. Now a big 20. Oh no, sorry, that wasn't in.
60.
So double top then for an early break of throw for the man from St. Helens. And he does so on double 10.
Well, a good start to the match there from Michael Smith. 14 darts. He'll take level 14s all the way, and that's another perfect dart.
99.
That's unlucky. The first dart was absolutely beautiful in the treble 20.
We saw Michael Mansell in Veldhoven, the Dutch Masters, where he reached the quarter final and lost to his Northern Ireland World Cup 60. Teammate Brendan Dolan. Brendan Dolan, one of the top 16 seeds in action tomorrow here in Berlin, where he'll take on the winner of the match between Kirk Shepherd and Marcel Horsiter. That's the first match on of the evening session, getting underway at 7 o'clock in the evening local time, 6 o'clock if you're watching us in the UK tonight.
100.
Another 8 first round matches, and then all of the 16 winners from today's first round go through to tomorrow's second round, where they take on one of the 16 seeds.
Well, if you were going to ask me, Mike, who do you fancy for this, I would have said Smith. He possesses that electrifying scoring power like the Lewis and the Van Gerwens. And at his age, he has got a brilliant future in the game. I suppose as long as he stays on the straight and narrow, as we call it. There's all young sportsmen. There's plenty of roads that he could go down apart from the main one. But just become a dad, as Michael Smith, so an extra mouth to feed, so may get extra serious on the dartboard.
100.
Yes, certainly sure to focus the mind, that's for sure. 128 then. He wants the bullseye, and he gets the bullseye for a 1-2-8 checkout. Blink and you'll miss him. Michael Smith finds himself 2-0 up against the man from Northern Ireland, Michael Mansell.
And these sort of players make the game look so easy. Did it make you sick at times? You know, there's Mickey here, been a good, solid professional for a long time, really has to concentrate and literally throw every dart. I know that sounds a bit silly to say that, but Michael Smith just gets up there and says, well, I'll just throw this one here, I've missed it. Okay, we'll follow it. And, you know, he just runs around the board getting trebles here. And, you know, he's so much like the Lewis of 10, 12 years ago. And as he progresses in the game, he'll just tighten up the loose darts and he will be a force to be reckoned with.
Yes, I was going to say a similar throwing style and speed to Adrian Lewis. But a former world youth champion, a winner of 5 youth titles. So he's been plying his trade and doing his apprenticeship, even though he's still only 23 years of age.
But when Gary Anderson came up to me and our media manager, Dave Allen, and asked, told us that he would like to sponsor a player, can you advise us? Well, there was no question that this man was at the top of the list at the time. Thank you very much, Michael.
Right on cue. But Mansell looking to stop the rot with 81 here. Double 12.
Yeah, great leg of darts there from Mickey Mansell. 11 darts. He will, you know, Mansell's got that sort of game where he can wear people down. He won't rush. He'll take his own time. Very deliberate. Mickey Mansell out in Ireland now. He's taking darts to the schools. Another one of the players that putting something back into it. Getting the maths back in the school. Nothing better than teaching kids their maths, their numbers, than playing darts.
57.
Yeah, certainly have to be quick at adding up and taking away to progress on the dart circuit, that's for sure.
If you make something fun, you know, it goes in the brain, you remember it better. And what better way of having a game of darts and remembering numbers, getting kids confident on the numbers. And that's what a lot of players are doing. Steve Brown started up a series of academies.
95.
Paul Madonna in Manchester now, got it in the Stockport College. Well, the game's in good shape.
Next up on the main stage here,
36.
Two of the European qualifiers who came through the qualifying matches last night, Magnus Karras. Very familiar name, been on the dart scene for many years, from Sweden, up against Jerry Hendricks. Then we have Jelle Klassen, former BDO world champion, against Jan Artut, and Joe Mernon against Andy Smith, the Pie Man, rounding off the afternoon session here at the Maritime Hotel in Berlin. Day one of the German Darts Masters.
85.
Welcome along if you're watching via live PDC TV or Corals or Bet365, the bookmakers.
96, with the Uruguay 157.
Well, a chance here for Mansell to put some pressure on. He knows that Smith may only get a dart at the bullseye. So one treble, well, he's done exactly that. He's going to put the pressure on. He's going to leave himself two darts at a double. That will be interesting to see where Smith goes. Will he go for that treble 20? Will he go for the 25 all ball? That's the 20, and he's missed it. He's hit the 8. That leaves 84. Going to go the treble 20. Well, he took the option of the 25 to leave the bullseye with his third dart and even missed that. So now Mansell a chance to level it up at 2 all.
Double 10 for the Cyclone. Just inside the wire to double 5. No messing, and we're all square then at 2 apiece. And that was against the throw.
Yeah, Smith got out of the gate very quickly, and there we have the averages. And Smith's still up at just under 90. Nine. Mansell 94.5, so both players playing a good game of darts. First nine average, pretty good from both players.
178.
A great side on view there, just to see the angle with which both players, similar angle with pointing up at the back. Very long barrels and short stems there from Michael Mansell's darts. Maybe more conventional from Smith in terms of design.
180.
And certainly they're doing him proud at the moment. With his third ton 80 of this match.
Well, six darts from here from Smith. It's another one of those.
85.
Not quite enough, and you can see his disgust in it. So now that opens the door for Mansell. Mickey needs to set this up. At least one dart in the treble. He's hit that. That's perfect. He's got to follow that up, surely. Come on over to the treble 13 now, it should be. Or is he going somewhere else? What else does he fancy? No.
133.
Good setup from Mantle. Really has put the pressure on this 136 of Michael Smith.
Double eight.
Game shot and the fifth left. Michael
Another
Smith.
Fantastic big out shot from Michael Smith. We saw him take out a 128. There he takes out a 136 to go 3-2 up.
Well, there we have it. Two of his three legs, 128 and 136. Not bad for him.
One hundred eight.
Leg six with another maximum. And that's why these sort of guys are so exciting to watch. You just don't know what's going to happen. One minute they're playing pretty poor, and the next minute they're just on fire. And we see that the first nine average is up to 117. 100. That's exceptional. And his overall average, 107. Four 180s. Playing at the top of his game at the moment, Smith, and he isn't stopping there. Are we on a nine dart leg?
Lucky was that.
Well, the crowd are loving this as well. On this Easter Saturday afternoon in Germany. They've been treated to some fantastic action this afternoon. And it's only the first afternoon, the first match of the afternoon going all the way. Jarkko Kamula edging out Ronnie Heibrecht 6-5.
105.
Ronnie Baxter beating Raymond van Barneveld in some style 6-2 earlier on. And still plenty of mileage left in this match between Michael Smith and Michael Mansell.
140. Mikey Uruguay, 76.
So for a potential 11 dart leg to go 4-2 up here, he wants double 8, double 4.
72. Mickey Uruguay,
well, this could upset the rhythm of Michael Smith. If Mansell can take this out, one of the biggest shots on the dartboard. Oh, and that's Plum. Look at that treble 17 down the bottom of the board now. That's unlucky. That was right on the wire. Well, now Smith, problem here, he puts the dart below. It's going to cover half the double, so he's got to attack it with the first dart. And that's what he's done. Now he can put one above it.
No score.
What a waste of a leg, Mike. I mean, you know, 4-2 up, you're thinking, right, I can get home and drive from here. Now, all of a sudden, it could be 3-3.
Yes, made a little bit of a mess of it as Smith, but can Mansell punish him? He wants a double 16 then.
Oh,
but doesn't do it. You can see the look on Mansell's face. He's let Smith back in. This awkward double two, no messing that time.
Michael Smith.
And there is now a two-leg advantage between Smith and Mansell. Smith needing just two more legs for victory and a place in round two against Mervyn King. But can the mercurial Northern Irishman find a response and claw his way back into this game?
100.
Well, there's one thing for sure with Mickey Mansell. You'll never see him give up. He'll keep doing his own thing. He probably said to him, now's Michael Smith's playing. He said, well, I know I'm losing. He's one of those players that plays his own game.
Good last start there, needed that.
108.
Smith, I should say, the other Michael, flying in with another ton 80. I'll make that his fifth of this match.
Oh, poor old Mickey, level tons, which is a brilliant scoring. But the power scoring of Michael Smith has put him on a checkout after nine darts yet again in this match. And he's gone for the double top route this time and finds the double top. A brilliant 11 dart leg from Smith. And the previous leg, his 11th dart was at double eight. So when we talk about power scoring, certainly Smith, he's entertaining the crowd with that.
And that was against the throw. He has the darts in hand here to book his place in round two of the German Darts Masters, with Mervyn King awaiting the winner of this one tomorrow. And another impressive showing by the young Englishman from St. Helens.
96.
Like I said earlier on, Mike, you know, he has got a bright future if he keeps focused. And I do believe, you know, having the child is going to make him keep focused. He's got another objective in his life now, another, as I said, mouth to feed. It does 95. Kind of wake you up when you've got a little baby around.
And Gary Anderson, who's looking after him, has become a dad recently himself, so they can compare notes on that front as well.
Possibly change nappies at the same time. I'm sure both of them will learn how to do that. I think not with Gary, perhaps. With Michael, I can see that, but not with Gazza.
Yes, reining in now the treble 20s.
140.
Wanted to go well high to avoid hitting a ton 80 and busting, but did so with style to leave double top then for the match. And at this rate, he's going to have at least six darts at it.
60. Michael Uruguay, 40.
They're well high, and that one was low, but he does have a bit of time. Mansell still not down to a finish. But he won't want to go round the houses like we saw him do earlier, Smith, and end up busting double two or anything like that. Or he'll want to get the job done, get back to his hotel room, and prepare for a second round match against Mervyn King. Double 10 then for Michael Smith. No messing that time.
And the match. Michael Smith!
And a solid victory for the young man from St. Helens over the Northern Irishman, Michael Mansell. So Smith through to round two. He'll be through to round two between Jerry Hendricks and Magnus Karras, two European qualifiers. They're on the big stage in a couple of minutes' time. Don't go away.
Michael Smith. Michael, congratulations. Average of 104. That's the best mark till that point in the tournament. Good.
It's not too shabby, is it? I think I missed about 10 darts at double as well, so it could have been over 110. But just nice to get the win and into the next round now. That's all that matters.
A lot of things happen in your life the last couple of weeks. Your son is born end of March. Is it different for you now to put the concentration, the focus on darts with this little one at home?
I have to now. I'm no longer playing for myself. I've got to play for my girlfriend and my baby as well. Plus Pampers cost a lot these days, so I've got to keep winning just to buy nappies. So, no, with him being born now, it's made me grow into a man. I'm not a boy anymore now. I've started to grow into a man and started playing darts proper now.
Gary Anderson is your manager. How important is he for your game? How in which way does he help you in your game?
He helps me the mental side because he's been there and done it. And with his scoring ability, that's all I want to do is score. And like you see before, when I missed, I still had another chance because I scored too high. So as long as I score, I know I'm going to win dart matches. And that's what Gary helps me with. He just helps me with just do this, do that. Just don't let nothing bother you. Don't let this and get on with your game. That's all he helps.
See you tomorrow again. Thank you very much. Michael Smith, Bully Boy. Er hat hier gezeigt. dass er in einer guten Verfassung ist. Wie gesagt, Ende März ist er Papa geworden und er sagte,